Good morning, Photoshop fans. My name is Ali Baba, and in this video tutorial, we're going to learn how to make eyes wiggle. That's right, wiggle. And this is the effect we are going for. Chick, 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 chick. Hello, darling. Hello. Anyway, that's enough of the silly voices and the stupid acting. Let's get straight into this. Now it's actually 7:30 in the morning here in Thailand. I've just had my morning coffee. I'm buzzing and I'm ready to make things happen. So, what are we going to do? First things first, you need a picture. Now I took this picture from a hard drive. This is a picture of a... I like this picture because it's a close-up of the face. It's got the big eyes. I like the eyes on it, so that's why I chose it. How it got on my hard drive, I will never know, but nonetheless it was there. You could go to Google, you could type in, faces, close-up of faces, and I'm sure you'll find hundreds of things that you can work with. So let's get started. What we want to do is, the first thing we want to do is we want to remove the iris. We want to make a copy of the iris so we can use it for ourselves later. Easiest way to do this is get the elliptical marquee tool, and by left clicking and dragging down, you want to make a selection of the iris. Now if you find it's hanging over, just simply hold down the space bar and it allows you to move the iris, move the marquee tool while having it selected. Okay, so I just want to just take the eye. That's about right, really. Okay, now I've selected it and now it's all on the iris. I can now use my arrow keys to left, right, just to get perfect selection. When you're happy with that, as I am, we want to make a new layer of it. So we want to hold down control, the picture layer selected, you want to hold down control and you want to hit J. And there you go, you can see our iris is just sitting there. In fact, if you double click on where it says layer 4 or whatever it says in your one, double click on it, and we just simply type in what we want. Okay, now I've got to move her, I'm going to move her iris and we're going to give her 3 eyes. There we go, sexy. Okay, next thing we need to do is we need to remove the actual old iris, so we can replace it with ours later. So we need to make this whole eye white. Okay, now the way I do this is I select the pen tool, it's right here, the pen tool, making sure that all the paths are selected. I'm going to zoom in here. Okay, click one corner of the eye, other corner of the eye, and holding down the left mouse, drag. Just drag it, baby, drag it. Now you see the end of the handles here, you have the pen tool cursor. And what we want to do is you want to hold down the Alt button and you see it changes to like an arrow. And with that held down and left clicking and dragging, we want to move this to about there, let go of Alt, let go of left mouse button, and click and drag. In fact, that's not the best, but it'll do. Same the other side, click, drag, hold down the Alt. It was too high last time, that's better, and okay. And there you have 2 selections of the eyes. Now we actually need to make these into a selection, a proper selection, where it looks like the ants are running around it. So by holding down control and hitting enter on your keyboard, it turns them into the ant selection. Next we need to make a new layer. With your layers palette open, which it's not open, here it is here, the little layers palette. With your layers palette open, go to the bottom, second icon from the end, create new layer, click it. Okay, that's made a new layer. And then we just simply need to fill the selected areas. There's many ways to fill the eyes. I find just grabbing the brush tool and just painting them over. You can fill them, you can do anything you want, but I just seem to do it that way, so that's the way I'm going to do it. Zoom out quickly. Next, what we want to do is we want to make a bit of, make the eyes look a bit more realistic. Okay, so I find the best way to do this is grab the burn tool, which is this hand. If you can't see it there, then simply hold down the mouse, left mouse button, and you'll see it come up, the dodge, the burn, and the sponge. We need the dodge tool. We need to make it a little bit bigger. You can do that by going to the top. We want a soft edge brush. I think 90 is okay. And what we want to do with that layer selected, the white layer selected, we just want to burn just a little bit in the corners to start with. Okay. Give it that. Give it some form of depth. Okay, next is, let's make the brush smaller. So let's bring it down. Let's just add some, nope, too much. Let's just add some around the edges. Just making it appear to be inside a id. Okay. Okay, right, it's looking a bit better. In fact, I might just do a little bit there. Okay, what we want to do now is we want to put the iris into the eye. Okay, so by clicking the iris layer and hitting the move tool, we pick up the eye and we put it into a head. Now, as you can see, it's actually going behind the whites of the eyes. That is because the layer is below it. So simply left click, drag the layer up, and that layer will be above it. Now what we need to do, we're going to run into a problem here. At the moment, if we were to move this eye ends up coming out everywhere, okay? But what we want it to do is, we want to, every time we move it, we want it to stay in the socket. So the little trick we're going to do now is we're going to clip the iris layer and the white layer together. To do this, go between the both of the layers, hold down the Alt key, and you'll see there's a little icon picks up, two circles with an arrow pointing to the left. Hold down Alt. Now all you need to do is left click between those two layers, and you have now just clipped them together. You can tell that because little arrow pointing down is telling you you've clipped to the layer below it. And now when you move it, it's inside the eyeball. Okay, now we just want to make a duplication. Okay, that's fine. The mark, that was with the mark U tool, just make an area around the eye. Now with the move tool, which is the top one, holding down Alt, you'll know you're holding down Alt because the cursor will change the two arrows. Holding down Alt, left clicking and drag, that will move the other eye into position. When you're happy with where it is, deselect, Control D, okay. And if you look now, they're both connected. So when you move one, you're moving both. Perfect. Probably the left eye is a little bit, yeah, it's a little bit different. Okay, I see a little problem here, and it's not looking very real. Is the white and the gray, the grays of the eyes, I mean, they're just not looking realistic. So we need to fix that. Go back to the layer 4, which is mine, which is the whites of the eye layer. At the bottom here, you need to choose this setting, create new fill or adjustment layer. It's a little circle with a line going between it. Click on that, left click on that, and choose color balance. Now what color balance is going to do, we can change the colors of the actual eye. So you can change there, okay. I normally go to about, I don't know, about 70 for the reds, and then bring the yellows down to, I don't know, about there, about minus 40. I mean, you can play with these settings, getting them a bit better, and then hit OK. Now if we move the iris, it looks a bit more realistic than it did with the grey. Okay, play around with it. If you've got any comments, leave them on my YouTube.